Hey people, thank you for stopping by at Building Wealth with Rajiv. Crypto market is undergoing a correction. Hopefully it's a short-term one. But never mind, I'm always looking out for some wealth building opportunities for myself and for you. So here I talk about Polygon Matic from the world of crypto. So this episode will cover quite a few things. Number one, what is Polygon Matic? Number two, what are the positives of Polygon Matic? Number three, what are the risks associated with Polygon Matic? What are the various price targets? Polygon Matic, and last but not least, whether it's investable, whether it could be a good long-term investment. Hope you enjoy the session. If you enjoy the session, please press the like button, share with your friends, follow the channel, and press the bell icon. So guys, without further delay, let's get started. Polygon, what is Polygon? Before we go into understanding what Polygon is, it's important to understand what is the mission of the company, because that drives the direction and then drives the results. So the mission of Polygon is very clear: to create a decentralized world, to create a world where people and machines can collaborate and exchange values without gatekeepers or intermediaries. This is pretty much any blockchain which is looking to decentralize is looking to do. So they're pretty much on spot. Many of you may not know or may know that this was called Matic Network earlier, and it was rebranded in February 2021 to give it a more holistic feel of what the company is. Now, how's the price of Matic, the coin, the Polygon has been over the last 1 year. As you can see here, it's a significant increase. It's thousands of percent increase it has gone through after it got started. And then after that, it's been a steep spike. It has been in a bit of a, consolidation. It's gone down, it's coming up, and then it's going down. So it's a bit of a consolidation phase. So now the question is whether it will take off in the next stage or whether it will keep consolidating. That's a very difficult question. But looking at the fundamentals, what happens, I think you can decide for yourself. Now, the important thing is that what problem does the Polygon solves? And that decides the success of Polygon. And why was it developed? So the important thing is to remember each blockchain. And as I talked last time when I was talking about Phantom, they're looking to address three things. That, they're looking to address security, they're looking to address scalability and decentralization. And that's called scalability trilemma. Now, Ethereum does it, but does it do it to an extent that it's good enough? Possibly no, because Ethereum is such a big network, very popular network. A lot of people are using. The speed is not that great until Ethereum 2.0 comes, which is planned for next year. So the scalability of Ethereum can be an issue. And that's where Polygon helps. So what Polygon does, it's kind of a side chain. And you can think of Polygon as a system of local roads alongside a congested major highway. And that major highway is nothing but Ethereum. So it kind of supports Ethereum in scalability. So you may not need to do the transactions directly in Ethereum. You can do in Polygon. And that will save you some of the transaction costs. That will save you the time. Let me show you that. Now, look at, these are the transaction costs. Now, if you look at Ethereum, because it's simply a question of demand and supply. So if you're doing any transaction, let's say in Ethereum transfer on Ethereum, it might cost about $14. This is the data from Polygon website. But if you do it from using Polygon network, it's a fraction of that. Simply because the demand for Ethereum is so high compared to supply that the transaction costs have gone up. Yeah. And also the speed of transaction on Ethereum is not so high at the moment. They're trying to increase it, and maybe by next year, we'll have a better news. Similarly, if you want to do an NFT transfer, if you use Ethereum, the cost is pretty high. But if you use Polygon, the cost is low. So Polygon helps you doing the work of Ethereum at a far lower cost. Yeah, and thus it helps Ethereum to transform into a full-fledged multi-chain solution, a far more effective multi-chain solution, I would say. Now, why should you buy or why should I be interested in Polygon, and why should you be interested in Polygon? The case study, the case the Polygon existence is very clear. It started as something which will support Ethereum, one of the biggest, most important network in the world of decentralized finance. So it solves a very, very important problem. So the existence is very, very relevant. Yeah. But what is it doing, Polygon, to remain relevant? It's creating good partnership. So it's creating partnership with other projects like Sushi, Aave, QuickSwap. So it kind of, it's a side chain. It's trying to build the partnership with Sushi, Aave, so that, you know, the transactions on these networks can also happen through Polygon. Recently, it has done partnership with Ernst & Young, which is pretty good. It's to develop and implement some kind of enterprise solution for Ethereum ecosystem. Now, when it's developed the enterprise solution for Ethereum ecosystem, it means that the larger corporate will be able to use it now, which is quite a big deal. It has created partnership with DraftKings. DraftKings is a listed company, very high profile company in US. They want to go into NFTs, so they want to use Polygon to enhance their blockchain capabilities. It has partnered with Google, where you can see the data of all the transactions which are happening in Polygon. Now it provides transparency. It provides, and the transparency helps building Polygon system as well as the Ethereum ecosystem. Other partnership, gaming. Gaming is a big thing. If you've seen the recent Metaverse thing, gaming is going to be a big thing. So it's partnering with major game players. It's Decentraland. Mana is one of the big Metaverse players, and something a pretty good investment also in my view. It has partnered with Decentraland to solve similar network lag issues. Polygon has committed about $100 million in support of decentralized games, NFT. So it's kind of a going into the ecosystem very heavily. A lot of fund management are interested in Polygon now, and trying to create funds which are specifically invested in Polygon. Now, this is also good, that it just simply means that more money will flow into Polygon. And, you know, again, it's a question of demand and supply that might affect the price. Now, this is a tweet which I saw from one of the co-founders of Polygon, which is talking about how Polygon is trying to play in the metaverse. So you can see that all the big metaverse players like Decentraland, Evolution Land, Sandbox, they're workable on Polygon, and it's trying to create relations with all of them. So Polygon would be a good player in the world of metaverse, which has a bright future. Now, this is a good data. If you see from this data from May 2021 to October 2021. The daily active addresses on Polygon are increasing, while on Ethereum, it's kind of on a bit of a decline. That just shows that people are moving on to Polygon because Ethereum has high transaction cost, high gas fees, and Polygon helps them. So this shows the acceptability of Polygon is going up. Revenue. If you see the total revenue of Polygon are going up, there are some months which is it's down, there are some months it's up, but overall it's an upward trajectory. One of the important factors is that how much value is locked in Polygon system. It's about 4.7 billion. Now, this is quite significant if you see 4.71 billion. But one thing which concerns me is that there was a point of time, before July or maybe in June 2021, it was so high. It was about 10 to 12 billion, so it's a steep fall from there. So one of the reasons which is being put forward is that Polygon has raised its gas fees, and which is resulted in less interest in Polygon. But this is something is going to be watched, because if a network is having less value locked, it's potentially not good. So this is something we'll have to watch. But for the moment, the total value locked in absolute looks pretty healthy. The team is very important, as you would know, and they're very young, hands-on, dynamic team. I've listened to the interview of Sandeep Nailwal on our India talk show called Chat with Ranveer or something, Ranveer Show. You can listen to that and you can find out the person is very promising. And they're all pretty geeky, very hands-on, the developer with a background, engineering background, who likes playing around with the things. So pretty solid team. Now, what are the risks to Polygon? The risks are that Ethereum is looking to upgrade. It's looking to increase its speed, it's the rate at which the transactions can be done. What will that do? That might make Polygon less relevant. That is one of the big risks. So they would have to find a way out, they would have to find, Polygon will have to find a way to be more relevant. Yeah. Now, what is it doing? So I think this is something to watch out, but team seems to have a vision. Polygon vision is, you know, they want to be internet of blockchains. So connecting all the blockchains, whether it's not limiting themselves to Ethereum, but going beyond that. So connecting Ethereum and other blockchains, also being useful to Ethereum within the Ethereum network. That is, so it's basically they're trying to emerge, evolve as an infrastructure as a service business model for all the blockchains, because other blockchains will also need, smaller chains which can connect them, to other chains and as well as reduce the traffic on them. And also it's possible that even though Ethereum extends, Ethereum, it becomes Ethereum 2.0 and, you know, the gas fees might reduce, but it's possible as the blockchain picks up, the Ethereum 2.0 upgrade may not be as much enough as people are thinking out to be. So Polygon will still remain relevant from that point of view. But there is competition in that space. There is Cosmos, there is a Polkadot, which are also kind of positioning themselves as, infrastructure as a service business model, which will be a competition to Polygon. But there will always be competition. So how Polygon looks at this competition, this is from Polygon website. You see that they consider themselves superior to Cosmos and Polkadot. Ethereum compatibility is one of the things which Polygon has, which Polkadot doesn't have. Developer experience, they think, is Polygon is higher, and there are other things which they think is scalability and sovereignty. They think they are better than Polkadot. But now this is from their website. You can take it with a pinch of salt. But Polygon management seems pretty confident in what they are. Now, what are the price targets for Matic? Now, nobody can know the future and what the prices could be. But these are a couple of companies like Government Capital, Wallet Investor, Digital Coin, and you can search them on Google as well. What are they saying? What could be the price target? So, for example, Government Capital is talking about $3.2 worth of price for Matic by the end of the year. Currently, it's about somewhere between $1.5 to $1.6. So it's about 100%, and it's 2 months left now, or 1.5 months left. It's a pretty good deal if this comes out to be true, as we don't know what will happen. But this is what some of these firms who do technical analysis and various things talking about. 5 year, again, it's difficult to look 5 year. What will happen in 5 years? We don't know. It's such a fast changing world. But what these companies are talking about, the price target of $10. Digital Coin is a little bit more conservative, talking about $5. But even if it settles somewhere between 10 and 5, let's say about 7, 7.5, that's about 4 or 5 times from here in 5 years, which is a pretty good investment. Now, nobody knows. Do your own due diligence, please. Now, what is, it's a bit of an interesting thing to look at the investment sentiment in Polygon. What caught my attention was obviously the market capitalization of Polygon is about 14.8 billion Singapore dollar. Now, if you look at Solana, it's about 90 billion. If you look at Ethereum, it's 679. So there is a leg room for Polygon to grow. Also, what is happening in Polygon, the typical hold time is about 71 days. In Ethereum, typical hold time is 73 days. And if you look at Solana, the typical hold time is 18 days. So it clearly shows that people who are holding Polygon, they're holding for the long term. Now, to me, it might be temporary, it might be permanent, we don't know, but it looks a fairly healthy trend. What should we do next? What is the investment, what is the right investment strategy for Polygon? Now, I can't decide for you. You have to decide for yourself. You have to do your own due diligence. Now, what am I doing? Number one, I personally find Polygon promising. I think it has a long-term future. They're in a good position. They're doing the right things for the future. So what I will do, and what I have done actually, is put a couple of $1,000s in Polygon as a beginning bet and as a start. And I would monitor how the Polygon is going to do in future, what steps, what partnerships are they building, how the execution is laying down, and especially in how they're preparing themselves for a post-Ethereum 2.0 world, where they will be so-called less relevant to Ethereum, how they're expanding beyond that, how they're making sure that they continue to survive and thrive in post-Ethereum 2.0 world. And according to that, I will keep adding some money. I'll dollar cost average as when the prices fall, just to maximize my gains. That's going to be my strategy. You can decide your own strategy, what you're going to do. For any crypto portfolio, it's highly, highly volatile. You got to see the price fluctuation in 1 day, 20%, 30% are pretty common. So you may want to take a portfolio approach where you don't put all your money in one crypto, but spread it around different cryptos with a long-term perspective. So that's what I'm looking to do. I've shared very openly with you. Hopefully you enjoy the session. Hopefully you find it useful. If you find it useful, follow the channel and see you soon.